please help me!
Dear Kane, please come to Sleepy Hollow to investigate the mysterious Headless Horseman case. I've heard a lot about your past success, and our city needs a constable like you. Moreover, this is your hometown, so I'm sure the locals will give you a warm welcome. Sincerely, Katrine.
What are these people gossiping about? I'd better grab my constable's orders and listen to them.
How awful. Who would want to kill a simple chronicler? He didn't have any enemies, and his only friends were books and quills.
Maybe he learned something he wasn't supposed to. It could have been about the witches. He did spend a lot of time in the old archives.
Is it true that witches have returned with the Headless Horseman? My goodness, I hoped I'd never heard the sound of those horseshoes again.
There's no evidence except for the Chronicle's blood. They say the horseman takes the heads of his victims as trophies. Can you believe that? Here. I'm so glad you've arrived. Did you see how many people are in the square? We're all shocked by the latest murder. Please, could you examine the corpse before the local police arrive? They'll only complicate everything. Here, I found this near the body.
Ah, Mr. Farvik. I've heard about your investigations in New York, and I'd hoped I'd never see you in my town again. Mind your business, and don't even think of coming near my daughter, Katrin. What's done is done. Don't stir up the past. Katrin, go home. Sheriff McCollins will keep an eye on you. Mr. Farvik, allow me to accompany you to the hotel.
Good evening. I'm Judge Barrett. You must be Mr. Varick. I'm so glad a competent constable has finally arrived to help us with the murder case. We've prepared our best room for you. I'll see you later.
I'm sorry I was so harsh with you in the square. The residents have gone wild since the latest murder, and I've become anxious. I have a lot of responsibility on my shoulders as the mayor. Here, I took the liberty of ordering you some warm tea. Please, drink it. It was cold outside.
Oh,
The fire's none of my business. The mayor told me to keep an eye on you, and that's exactly what I plan to do. Don't worry. The firemen must be on the way there. Ah, I forgot to give you a letter from Judge Barrett. Here, read it.
I'll try driving him back to his senses.
Thank you for bringing me around, Catcher. Seems to you your father prepared me and had a soporific effect. Someone must have set my room on fire while I was asleep. The Arcs might have left some evidence.
Please, could you help me?
I'll search this room, and you can examine the surrounding area.
Here. This may be useful.
It's Father's cufflink. Link. But how did it get here? Was that the Headless Horseman? Where is everyone?
Look, is that that cape from their castle?
Shh! The mayor told us to keep a low profile.
Kane was right. Everything was planned. Thank goodness I noticed the fire. We have the same flammable liquid in our house. It's quite expensive, so not many people buy it. Isn't that my father's pipe? Maybe he stayed in this room before and left it here?
I can't be certain, but it seems that your father tried to burn the room and kill me. I'm not in a position to judge, but the evidence proves he was involved. We should go to your house. I must talk to Mayor Van Tassel.
Good evening, sir. I'm Sheriff McCollins. The mayor wants to see his daughter at the town hall. Please, stay here and wait for the guards. I was told someone set your room on fire, but since you were alone, you're the main suspect.
Let me go! He's not to blame! It was arson, and you need to investigate!
Thank you.
Stay here on patrol. Everyone should be home by now, so don't let anyone loiter around here.
I won't come with you. I know everything. I can't believe my own father attempted to murder someone.